Hi, I am Elena. For the next 3 minutes, we're going to talk about neuroscience.
Hi again. This is Mike.
And this is where Mike's brain is.
And this is where his spinal cord is located.
These are the two components of the central nervous system.
Ow!
How Mike's brain can separate a pinch from a touch, though? The answer partially lies in really small bumps that they are located right next to the spinal cord. Let's have a closer look at these structures. Dorsal root ganglia, which is their official name, are part of the peripheral nervous system. The signal is transferred from the periphery to the dorsal root ganglia, then to the spinal cord, and finally up to the brain. When this fine-tuned system is disrupted, issues similar to the broken telephone game can arise, where the initial signal is completely messed up through the way. The fine-tuning of the system happens thanks to highly specialized cells inside the dorsal root ganglia called sensory neurons. These neurons have two branches. The peripheral branch extends from the cell body to the organs at the periphery, collecting signals from the skin, joints, and muscles, and the central branch extends from the cell body to the spinal cord, transmitting those signals. Sensory neurons can be classified based on their sensitivity to a specific signal and the signal's intensity. Some neurons only respond to a single harmless or noxious stimulus, while others respond to a variety of inputs and intensities, as we can see in this oversimplified graphical presentation. Now that the basics of signal processing have been revealed, let's go back to my project. Painful conditions like arthritis or musculoskeletal pain are associated with a decrease of pH or acidification in local tissue and the environment surrounding the neurons. Acid-sensing ion channels are the main sensors of acidification within the dorsal root ganglia, and they are located at the wrapping layer of the neurons, the membrane. ASICs have several different subunits with unique properties, and they have emerged as key players in pain management. My project's aim was to investigate their expression pattern in different neuronal populations within the dorsal root ganglia, which is essential to better understand their implication in sensing different kinds of stimuli from the periphery. And this is where science happens. After countless hours of experimenting, troubleshooting, and analysis, I am very pleased to reveal to you the key results of my project. My work revealed a complicated expression pattern, which implies that each one of these ASIC subunits might be involved in sensing different signals. Moreover, peripheral injury affects the presence of ASIC subunits in pain-sensing populations, further supporting the idea that ASICs would be good targets for further drug development against pain. If you're more interested, check out my recent paper. Thanks a lot for watching, and take care!